Hey, good morning students. Let us solve some more problems based on the curve of the vector. So two unsolved problems are left. Let us finish those two unsolved problems and then we'll go for the next topic, that is vector identities. And the next problem number is problem number 17. And you are asked to show that the vector field V bar is equals to 2xy minus z cube into I bar plus x square j bar minus 3xz square plus 1 k bar is conservative. What do you mean by conservative field? Conservative field means irrotational vector field. So ultimately, conservative vector field, that means you have to show that the given vector is irrotational. Please remember, irrotational and conservative are one and the same. So do calculate the curl of the given vector v bar, and we know that curl of the vector is calculated with the help of a determinant I, j and k. So this is dou by dou x, dou by dou y and dou by dou z. And the third row will be the component of I, j, k of the given vector v bar. This is equals to 2xy minus z cube. This is the first component of the third row. The second component of the third row is x square. And the third component of the third row will be minus 10 3xz square plus 1. That's all. Now to calculate this. Now this is equals to a vector I bar into dou by dou y of this. Now this term do not contain any y term. So this is equals to a 0 minus dou by dou z of this. No z. So this is again a 0. Minus j bar into dou by dou x of this and dou by dou z of this. So dou by dou x of this is equals to this, and this will be equals to minus 10 6 j, right? Because 3 into 2 will be 6, and we are calculating minus 10 j bar into dou by dou x of this. That means you should differentiate this with respect to x. And if you differentiate with respect to x, then you will get minus 10 3z square. So this is minus 10 3z square. Got it? Minus dou by dou z of this. Minus dou by dou z of this will be equals to minus minus 10 minus of 3z square. So plus 3z square. Got it? Yes. And plus k bar into dou by dou x of this will be 2x. Dou by dou y of this will be 2x minus 10 2x. So this is 0. This will be 0. And this is also 0. So all components goes to 0. And then I can say the curl of the given vector is equals to 0. This indicates that the given vector field V bar is a conservative vector field. Hope you have understood this problem also. Now let us move on for the next problem. And your next problem is that we left out in the last video. So the next problem is this one. Next problem is problem number 13, and it is if A bar and B bar, are irrotational, then show that vector product of A bar and B bar is solenoidal. Then show that this is equals to a solenoidal. So this is the problem. Now in order to solve this, show that curl of the vector A bar is equals to, and this is I bar, J bar and K bar. And what is this component? Dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z. What are the third row components? Are the components of the given vector A bar. So those components are Ax, Ay and Az. Got it? And if you solve this, then you will get this is equals to I bar into dou Az by dou y minus dou Ay by dou z minus j bar into bracket dou by dou x. So dou Az by dou x minus dou Ax by dou z plus k bar into dou Ay by dou x minus dou Ax by dou y. Right? Now it is given that this is irrotational. If this is irrotational, that means these components are equals to 0, that means dou Ay by dou Az by dou y minus is equals to dou Ay by dou z. And next terms. No? Hope you understood this one also. The same the case, same is the case with curl of the vector A bar. Right? And what you will get curl of the B bar, that will be equals to only the change is this. Bx, By, Bz. Got it? I need to determine this vector again. Let us do that again. Okay. So curl of B bar will be equals to I bar, J bar, K bar, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, and dou by dou z. What are the components of B bar? Is a Bx, By, and Bz. And this is equals to I bar into dou by dou, dou Bz by dou y minus dou By by dou z minus j bar into dou Bz by dou x minus dou Bx by dou z. Dou z plus k bar into what will be this one? This is dou by dou x of By. So dou By by dou x minus dou Bx by dou y. And of course, this is equals to 0. This is equals to 0 means what? This component is equals to 0, this component is equals to 0, and this component. It again means this is equals to this. Now let us solve A bar cross B bar and then show that it is a solenoidal. So A bar cross B bar is the cross product of A bar and B bar. And how to calculate the cross product of A bar and B bar? Again use the determinant, but the component of determinant here are different. So the first row of this determinant is ijk, second row is the component of A bar, and third row is the component of B bar. Component of A bar are Ax, Ay and Az. The component of B bar are Bx, By and Bz. Right? And if you solve this, then you will get this is equals to I bar into what? Ay, Bz minus az by minus j bar into ax bz minus az bx plus k bar into ax by minus ay bx. Got it? So you got the curve of the vector, right? And if you make this j bar is equals to a positive, then you will get this term as a negative, this is as a positive. So you can write it either way, no issue. Now show that this is the solenoid of this vector is equals to a 0, and in order to show that the solenoidal, that means dot product or a divergence of A bar cross B bar, you should get this is equals to a 0. And what is this? This is nothing but I bar into dou by dou x plus j bar into dou by dou y plus k bar into dou by dou z. Dot product of this with this bracket. And what is this bracket? This bracket is nothing but above relation. I did not write it again, right? And if you take the dot product, then you will get I dot I is equals to 1, and you can easily find out that dou by dou x of this term do not contain any x, so you will get this is equals to a 0. And j dot j is 1, and if you take the dou by dou y of this term, and you find that there is no term of y in the bracket, so you will get again here 0 is equals to dou by dou z of this is again a 0. And therefore, ultimately, the divergence of this term is equals to a 0, which implies that the divergence or the dot product of A bar cross B bar is equals to 0. And this is the solution of this problem. Hope you understood this problem also. So let us rough out this, and thus we have solved all unsolved problems based on the curve of the vector. And let me move on the next topic, and let us check how much time is left for us. Let's go for the vector identities and solve the first vector identity. Yes. So the next topic is a vector identities, and this is the last topic of this chapter. Vector identities. Now let us go for the first vector identity and then the problem based on this. The first vector identity is, let me check it. The curl of the gradient of the scalar phi is a 0. What is the first term identity? The curl of the gradient of the scalar phi is equals to a 0, right? Curl of the gradient of the scalar is equals to 0. Got it? Now this is a kind of a problem only based on the vectors. You can just use the formulas for the curl of the vector and the gradient of the scalar, and you'll get the answer easily. So let us do that. Right. So let us show this is equals to 0. So let me rough out this and continue to solve the problem. So what is this curl? So curl of, now use the formula for the gradient of the phi, and we know that gradient of phi is written as I bar into dou by dou x of phi. So let me write dou phi by dou x plus j bar into dou phi by dou y plus k bar into dou phi by dou z. Right? Now how to find out it's a curl? If you want to find out it's a curl, then the curl of this is nothing but a determinant of I bar, j bar and k bar. And how to find out it's a determinant? The first component is dou by dou y, the second rows, first component dou by dou x, dou by dou y and dou by dou z. What is the third row? Third row is what? The component of I, j, k. And what is the component of I, j, k here? It is dou phi by dou x. This is dou phi by dou y. And this is dou phi by dou z. Right? And if you solve this curl, then after solving this, you will get I bar into bracket dou by dou y of this. And I can write directly dou 2y by dou 2 phi, because there is a phi, no? So dou 2 phi by dou y dou z, dou y dou z minus dou 2 phi by dou 2 phi by dou y dou z or dou z dou y. Minus j bar into bracket dou 2 phi by dou x dou z minus dou 2 phi by dou 2 phi by dou z dou x plus k bar into bracket dou 2 phi by dou x dou y minus dou 2 phi by dou y dou x. Right? And if you observe this very carefully, this term and this term are same, the syndicates, you will get this equals to 0, which is very simple. And hence, I can say, or this implies that the curl of the gradient of the scalar phi is equals to 0, and this is proved. Hence I can say in words also, thus the curl of gradient of the scalar of the scalar is 0, and this is proved. Hope this identity also you have understood, and let us do one more identity. Let us do the one more identity. And what is that identity? The identity is Yes. Del dot del phi is del square phi. Del dot del phi. Show that del dot del phi is equals to del square phi. That means Laplacian operator. Del square is a Laplacian operator, no? So let us solve this. What is this del dot del phi? Del dot del phi is equal to del means what? It's a vector differential operator. I bar into dou by dou x plus j bar into dou by dou y plus k bar into dou by dou z dot divergence of this with a gradient of the scalar. What is gradient of scalar? Is I bar into dou phi by dou x plus j bar dou phi by dou y plus k bar into dou phi by dou z. If you take the dot product, then this dot product will be I dot I is 1 and you will get this is equals to dou 2 phi by dou x square plus j dot j is 1, so dou 2 phi by dou y square plus dou 2 phi by dou z square, and this is equals to, I can take out phi common and I will write dou 2 by dou x square plus dou 2 by dou y square plus dou 2 by dou z square into phi. Got it? And what is this bracket? This bracket is nothing but del square. I'll write phi as it is because phi is a scalar component, and hence I can say the del dot del phi is equals to 0, and hence I can say thus this identity is proved, which is very simple. Just enter the values of divergence and the value of the gradient of the scalar point function, right? So hope you understood this identity also. And with this identity, we'll end this video or this lecture. And in the next video, we will see some more identities based on the this topic. And we'll solve some problem based on the same topics also. Thank you.